Bahrain qualifying is nearly upon us, and the drivers look as if they're all geared up to go. I expect we'll be getting underway very shortly.
Further back than we'd like, but don't worry about it. Just means more fun for us tomorrow.
We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Vettel, Hamilton, and Carter. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry. We'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. There's something in the Bahrain air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the sand. Our brightest minds have thrust their brightest ideas into the spotlight of the Sakhir circuit this evening as we look ahead once more to a Grand Prix that has thrilled us so consistently in the past. Formula One returns to the desert today on this exceptional 3.36 mile circuit. 15 corners provide plenty of overtaking opportunities. It could be a strategic race, this one, with Sakhir notorious for eating up the rear tyres. Watch out for drivers managing their rubber at some point during the Grand Prix. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Let's talk about Carter. That was a great podium in the last race. So can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Carter, Butler, Max Verstappen, and Faber, Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Grosjean, and Sergio Perez, Norris, Raikkonen, Lance Stroll, and Kvyat, Sainz, Albon, Robert Kubica, and Antonio Giovinazzi. Ricciardo, they've taken a grid penalty, and George Russell ends our grid lineup. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. I start. Has been enabled. The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. This lap, push hard on the in-lap. This set of boots. We have started to notice some wear. We should be okay for a bit longer though. this lap and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalised if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach. Stops. This is 2.9 seconds. On these tires. We'll be right back. battery is low on energy, reduce ERS deployment. Laps of fuel remaining. Reduce ERS deployment. Fuel target is is plus one. Faster engine modes are available.
Well, what a drive that was to take the win for Ferrari today. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. This round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Our championship leader is still sat at the top of the standings, but their rivals have made up some solid ground today. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Daniel Ricciardo certainly impressed me today, an incredible performance.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari take the lead at the top of the table. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.